What's up, guys, and welcome to One Take. I'm Gil, and tonight I wanted to talk once again about Twin Peaks. Unfortunately, I am in a hotel room right now, which means I don't have the same special effects as last time. No red curtain, no suit and tie, and unfortunately, it's a little bit too late for coffee. Actually, you know what? It's never too late for coffee, so we're gonna do this Dougie Jones style. If you're unfamiliar with the rumors that popped up a few weeks ago about a potential season 4 of Twin Peaks, you may want to check out my other Twin Peaks videos where I discuss those rumors to get caught up. Since then, there really haven't been many further developments to either reinforce those rumors or make them go away. Kimmy Robertson, one of the actresses from the show, did say that she doesn't know anything about another season of Twin Peaks. But that doesn't really definitively tell us anything one way or the other. It really depends on where in the development cycle they are with the season 4. If it's just in the stage where David Lynch, Mark Frost, and Showtime are talking about it, it's possible that the actors wouldn't yet be in the loop. Also, it's true that Mark Frost, David Lynch, and Showtime, none of them have gone out of their way to squash these rumors. And I think it's fairly likely that by now, based off of the number of people who have talked about them and reported them online, I'm sure that all parties involved have heard about these rumors. I also wouldn't read too much into the fact that they haven't commented on them. The truth is, they may hear rumors like this all the time, and so they sort of feel like, at least David Lynch and Mark Frost might feel like, you know what? We always hear these rumors. If I shoot these ones down, I have to go out of my way to shoot all of the rumors down, so I'm not gonna bother. And from Showtime's standpoint, it can't hurt that people are talking about Twin Peaks, so they might be saying, you know what, we're gonna sit back and let people talk about this. Maybe more people will come subscribe to Showtime and check out Twin Peaks The Return, so we're gonna let that rumor mill keep turning. So on the rumor front, I'd say really not much has changed. What I really wanna focus on today is the question of, should there be more Twin Peaks? Looking at my last couple of videos, I saw a lot of mixed reactions to the very idea of there being more Twin Peaks. Some people were like me, where they were psyched at the prospect of a potential continuation. Other people took the opposite attitude, saying we got a definitive, satisfying conclusion with Twin Peaks Season 3, and I don't even want any more Twin Peaks. So I gave it some thought and wanted to share with you some of my thoughts on whether or not we had a definitive conclusion, whether or not Twin Peaks is even the sort of thing where you can have a definitive conclusion, and ultimately, whether or not there should be more Twin Peaks. For me, I don't look at Twin Peaks as something with a definitive beginning, middle, and an end. I look at Twin Peaks as a big world full of interesting characters, a rich mythology, and its own unique aesthetic, which has evolved over time and speaks to everything from the unique score and music of Twin Peaks to just the general look and feel of the show. This is a world that Mark Frost and David Lynch have used to tell many interesting stories and explore many different themes. From a story, plot, narrative standpoint, to me, the only limitation on this world is the limits of David Lynch and Mark Frost's imagination. If you look back at the history of Twin Peaks, you don't see a series of story blocks that each follow naturally from the previous one and ultimately come together to form the ultimate Twin Peaks story. For example, if you think back to the original couple of seasons of Twin Peaks, in my opinion, there is no way that David Lynch and Mark Frost back then were thinking about Dougie Jones, who we saw in Twin Peaks The Return. So the fact of the matter is, many stories have been told in the Twin Peaks world, and there isn't one definitive story arc you can point to and say the entire series has come to a natural conclusion. You could say that the original premise of the show was the mystery of who killed Laura Palmer. That question was answered in the second season, and I know that that was against David Lynch's will, but ultimately, David Lynch and Mark Frost were able to reinvent the story, and with Twin Peaks Season 3, take it in a very different an interesting direction. To me, Season 3 was a masterpiece and proves that this world can be used to tell very different stories, both in a very successful and artistically interesting way. The only risk to continuing the story is either A, it becomes uninteresting and boring, and in my opinion, that is just not a risk when David Lynch is involved. If he comes back to tell more stories, the one thing we can say for sure is that it's not going to be what we expect and it's not going to be boring. The other risk is that somehow the continuing plot diminishes what we saw before, or somehow contradicts some themes or some statement the show has made previously. But I don't really see that as a risk. For one, like I said before, the show has been used to explore many themes. If you look back at the beginning of the show, it started out by looking at the far-reaching consequences of one girl's murder, or the darkness that hides behind the idyllic scene of a small town, or it was a meditation on grief and trauma. If you look at The Return, many of those themes were still there, but you can add into the mix, it looks at the dangers of a human playing in the realm of gods. When you look at Dale Cooper and his attempts to take matters into his own hands with time travel, season 3 also contained some commentary and some meditation on the idea of nostalgia. I'd also say that if you're afraid that Twin Peaks is going to somehow contradict one of its own themes or break something that came previously, I don't think that's really something you should be afraid of. I think that's a fear which stems from the idea that Twin Peaks is this self-contained puzzle which has an ultimate solution. And I know there's a 4.5 hour video going around on YouTube which proclaims to have solved all of Twin Peaks, and I've started watching that video. It's a good video and I do plan to finish it, but I don't think Twin Peaks is the sort of thing which can ultimately be solved. The fact of the matter is that this is a work of art that's been in progress for over 25 years. Even if David Lynch and Mark Frost were going into this with definitive ideas of what they're going to say, no matter how good artists they are, I don't think it's possible that they can return to a series 25 years later and be totally consistent with those original ideas. Not to mention the fact that Twin Peaks is a collaboration between two people. And again, I don't think it's possible for their two different unique ideas to meld together into one perfect solvable puzzle. In fact, I think we've seen some of these contradictions already. If you look at the ending to Fire Walk With Me, in my opinion, it ends on a pretty optimistic note with Laura Palmer looking up at angels. Then you go to The Return, which ends, in my opinion, on a very pessimistic note with Dale Cooper and Laura Palmer seemingly lost in another dimension. And the show seems to be making a statement that good is doomed to fail in its pursuit of defeating evil. Now, we can argue over the specifics of the plot in both of those instances, Fire Walk With Me and The Return, but one thing I think David Lynch communicates unambiguously is mood. And he chose to end Fire Walk With Me on a positive mood and end The Return on a very negative mood. When you choose to end a movie or a series hitting on a particular emotion, I think you are trying to say something. And the fact that the movie and the series ended on such different notes tells me that David Lynch and Mark Frost have both changed as human beings over time, and to expect them to have totally consistent themes in this 25 to 30 year exploration is unrealistic. And I don't mean that as a criticism. All I mean by that is what I said earlier. Twin Peaks is a world. In some ways, it's an artistic tool to explore different ideas, different themes, and at the end of the day, tell great characters with great stories. And I don't think there's a limit to that besides what David Lynch and Mark Frost are willing and interested in doing. So, can there be more Twin Peaks without diminishing the original? I think The Return definitively tells us that yes, there can be more because Lynch and Frost have shown their ability to tell very different stories in this world, but equally successful. Should there be more Twin Peaks? To me, that all comes down to one question. Yes, Twin Peaks is a world that you can use to explore artistic ideas, but do we want anyone to pick up that world and play with it? besides David Lynch and Mark Frost? I think the answer to that question is no. So it all comes down to, do they have more ideas in mind? Do they want to spend more time in this world? And if the answer to that question is yes, I, and I imagine many of you, will 100% renew our subscription to Showtime or wherever the series ends up, and we'll be there to watch it. And last thing I'll say is that I thought of a great Twin Peaks pun, which I was really hoping to work organically into this video, but unfortunately it just didn't work. So now I'm just going to throw it unnaturally in at the end here. So, what was Dale Cooper up to for almost the entirety of season 3? Well, as Dougie Jones, he was attempting to recuperate. Anyway, those are my thoughts on a potential continuation of Twin Peaks, but what are your thoughts? If you were opposed to the idea of more Twin Peaks, have I swayed your opinion at all, or do you think I'm getting something wrong somewhere in this analysis? If you're in favor of more Twin Peaks, what would you want to see? Would you want to see something focused on Richard and Carrie Page in this alternate reality, or would you want to see David Lynch and Mark Frost somehow return to the Twin Peaks that we know from the original series? Do you think there's even a possibility of more Twin Peaks at this point, or do you think that ship has sailed? Leave your thoughts in the comments below and let's get the discussion going. Anyway, if you enjoyed this video, make sure to hit the like button, subscribe to this channel, and hit the little bell icon to make sure you get notifications whenever we make more videos like this one. Thanks for watching.